Logan?
Logan what?
Sherman.
Do you play video games?
Yeah.
What games you playing?
Probably Kingdom Hearts.
What's that about?
It's very hard to explain in some manners. I know for a fact there's a lot about Keyblades and people with hearts that can lose them, thus creating Heartless and Nobodies. The tons of stuff, and the newest game came out this year, Kingdom Hearts 3, which is actually the 10th game in the series. It's very confusing in that regards. Three of the main characters are Sora, Riku, and Kairi.
Hello, friends! Today, we're going to dance! So everyone, get up! Come on, everyone, stand up! Because... it's time to dance!
Thank you, try.
When I'm by your side, ooh, every moment takes me to paradise. Darling, let me hold you.
The word of the week is camaraderie, which means trust among friends.
There was camaraderie within the small group.
How will you use camaraderie?
It's Friday. Congratulations, you made it to the end of the week. Stay tuned for our weekly news.
Spring diving clinics will take place at the Pickwell YMCA from 3:30 to 5 every Tuesday. See Senorita Trion if you have any questions.
Anyone interested in playing tennis this spring, there will be an informational meeting Friday directly after school in Coach Gillespie's room 109. The final blood drive of this year will be on Friday, March 15th. Your homeroom teacher will be passing out permission slips to anyone who is 16 that would like to make an appointment.
Once you have your parent permission form signed, see Ms. Watson 225 to get your appointment. First come, first serve.
Mandatory preseason parent meeting for spring sports will be held at Pickwell Junior High School February 27th at 6 p.m. All student athletes and parents should plan on attending if you did not play a winter or fall sport. We will be discussing concussions, nutrition, and drug screens.
Welcome to Black History Month. This week, we will be focusing on Madame C.J. Walker. Madame C.J. Walker ended up creating one of the first African-American hair product businesses.
She promoted her products by traveling and giving lecture demonstrations and eventually established Madame C.J. Walker Laboratories to manufacture cosmetics and train sales beauticians. Her business acumen led her to be one of the first American women to become a self-made millionaire.
Muhammad Ali was never one to back down from a fight. Inside the ring, his sheer toughness awed his opponents, and outside it, his determined eloquence provided moral leadership to many.
He stood against the Vietnam War long before that was a popular stance, spoke out repeatedly against racism, and later campaigned against Islamophobia in the U.S. followed by the 9/11 attacks.
3 years when he was in his sporting prime, Ali was banned from boxing by the U.S. authorities after he refused to be inducted into the U.S. Army because of his opposition to the Vietnam War.
It was a punishment Ali was willing to take, saying in response to a 5-year prison sentence, which he successfully appealed, for refusing to fight, "So what? We black people have been in jail for 400 years.
At age 18, the young Cassius Clay, as he was named at birth, got his first taste of how little his victories in the ring mattered in segregated America.
4 years later, in 1962, just after Ali had been beaten Sonny Liston to become world heavyweight champion, he joined the radical black civil rights movement, the Nation of Islam, and changed his name to Muhammad Ali.
We'll see you next week.
What up, Pickwell? It's me, your boy Drake, and I'm with...
Grisey.
And this is the ramen question. I'm here with...
Zen.
Okay, Zen. Do you pronounce it ramen or ramen noodles?
Ramen.
Definitely ramen. I'm here with...
Mrs. Allen.
Okay, Miss Allen. Do you pronounce it ramen or ramen noodles?
Ramen.
Definitely ramen. I'm here with...
Oil cans.
Alright, oil cans. Do you pronounce this ramen or ramen noodles?
It's ramen noodles. Duh.
I'm with
Cole. All
right, Cole. Do you pronounce it ramen or ramen noodles?
I guess ramen's the closest. I like to call it ramen. It's actually my favorite 5-star gourmet Italian meal.
Very interesting. Today I'm with...
Allie.
Okay, Allie. Would you pronounce this ramen or ramen noodles?
Ramen.
Exactly. I'm with...
Huh?
I'm with...
Owen.
Oh, yeah, Owen. Do you pronounce this ramen or ramen noodles?
Well, first of all... what is this?
It's Japanese ramen.
Don't care about this. Get this out of my face.
Andre.
This is Beely.
And this is your weekly sports report.
Boys basketball lost on Friday versus Troy at home. Girls basketball lost on Saturday in Troy versus Springfield. Wrestling has sectionals this weekend in Centerville. Boys basketball has a game this Friday at Trotwood versus Centerville.
This is Lauren.
And Jake.
We're going to take you on an inside look of how our PHS students dress on a day-to-day basis.
Let's go find some people.
Whoop, whoop. Got our first person, Grise. Tell me about your outfit and what inspired it.
I didn't have anything else clean in my closet.
What was that?
I didn't have anything else clean in my closet.
Take me through the shoes to the top.
These are the boots that I always wear. New vest, t-shirt.
Is that a new vest? Is that what?
New vest.
Can I have your name?
Dante.
What are you wearing today and what inspired the look? I see it has a lot of a pop of red.
It's my favorite color.
Red's your favorite color?
Yeah.
All right, take me through it.
A North Face jacket, some bottom jeans, and my red jacket.
Swag. Skeez, what the heck are you wearing?
Con los terroristas.
Remember your defense. Points come. Concentrate, focus, power. Remember balance. Make cool fight.
Welcome to this week of Picklepedia.
This week we'll be talking about the history and present of the Pickle High School athletics.
To begin, sports and academics go hand in hand, motivating students and improving responsibilities between teachers and coaches.
Going back to 1928, Pickle Athletics has been associated with the Miami Valley League.
Then the GMBC League in the mid-90s and the GWAC in the 2000s.
However, next year, Pickle Athletics will be associated with the Miami Valley League once again. Here today, we have Gabe Schweitzer. As a student athlete, what changes have you seen in the sports departments that you like?
I've seen more coaches, better equipment. Girls basketball, they have improved they've been better actually than any other past years. And like in swim, most of us made it to finals and some of us even placed in finals.
That's great.
Hey man. There's nothing more important that's happening in life right now, right here in high school, by these lockers.
I've got so many problems.
Hey, let me tell you something. There's nothing that staring at a lake can't fix.
High school is such a serious thing. These problems matter.
I'm Dylan, and I'm here with
Mrs. Hoing.
Today we're going to be asking, what was the craziest thing that you've done during high school?
The craziest thing I did in high school was I accidentally started a school-wide food fight during lunch. It was awful, and I didn't mean to, and I don't recommend anyone ever do it.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome.
Hello, Dylan.
Hi.
So, what do you think about the part with the flaming tires and Back to the Future?
Well, I don't think it's physically possible, but a little bit of movie magic it is. I think like the science of it is maybe like the hot tires of it warming up, mixed with the traveling 88 miles per hour with the cold asphalt, causes the car to move with friction, which causes the fire to go behind it.
Makes sense.
Hey Dylan, so have you ever just smacked your head onto something and had a wacky harebrained idea?
I don't think so.
Well, that's what Doc Brown did in Back to the Future. What do you think of that? Can you just like smack your head on something really hard and just whoosh, flux capacitor?
Oh, this is heavy.
Maybe not by itself. Maybe before his eyes closed, he saw like the picture of it in his head.
So why was it called Back to the Future if they went back into the past?
Well, the Back to the Future part comes in, where Marty is trying to get from the past to the future to help save Doc Brown.
So Marty went back into the past and went into the future past the present?
No. He used the DeLorean to go back in time to escape the Libyans. He did it on accident. And then he spends the rest of the movie trying to figure out how to get back to the future, while also trying to fix his parents' soon-to-be marriage.
So this future that he's trying to get back to, is that the present? Or in the past, is the present technically the future?
It's Friday, gotta get down on Friday. Everybody's looking forward to the weekend.